this idea that women often have, that we have to give in certain ways that we might like to be given to in order to win the love of a man. And what I've learned is that if a woman gives too much, too fast, too soon in the early stages of a relationship, it can actually short circuit what she hopes would happen. And I think this idea that you've just shared about men needing to feel successful by knowing they've made you happy by giving to a woman can actually be really empowering to a woman to help her navigate some of the challenges that she might feel in the early stages of a relationship, and particularly this temptation to overgive in ways that might feel good to her but might not work the same way for a man. So I'd love for you to expand on that. I hope that made sense. It was a little bit of a convoluted question.
Actually, it was a great statement as well, and you just want me to talk more about it, but you perfectly nailed one of the greatest things for women to understand is, let me reverse it around. How did I win over my wife, but by giving more? You win over a woman. If you're a man, I teach men, you want to seduce a woman, be attentive, be interested, ask her questions, be a good listener, support her, offer to help, call her up, let her know that you miss her. You know, these are all actions showing that she's special and important. And that's what she needs. Give her what she needs and she will want you. There's a relationship between desire and need. If you understand what a woman needs, you can seduce her. That would be how I got my wife to love me, basically. Men need to earn a woman's love by providing what she needs. Women don't need to earn the right guy's love. We have a little radar that says, okay, potential woman here, potential woman here, potential woman here, and it's called desire. Desire is built into men. That's our masculine side. And if I want food, okay, and I can't get it right away, what do I feel then? A greater need for food. What you want is a man to connect with his need for your approval, for your appreciation, for you. And the way he feels a greater need is to have not get what he wants right away. Biologically, you know, this is not necessarily the human part of him, but it's the drive back here and the primitive instinctive brain inside of a man. As much as this is a cliche, men biologically are designed, if a woman smiles, to want to have sex with her. Okay, just to put it that way. It's just, there's a strong desire, and you'll have more desire for one woman than another. And you don't know why you have it. You know, you're surprised sometimes, but you'll just get turned on if you're a guy. She didn't have to do anything. It's so important that women have to get that. You don't do anything, but you have to be yourself, be authentic, be fulfilled within yourself. So then a guy comes along, I'm wanting. To want is to not have. So literally he's feeling this sort of not having. And if I don't have food, I want to eat and I don't want to eat. I want to eat and I don't have the food. I'm going to keep wanting, right? As soon as I eat the food, I don't want the food. I'm ready to move on to something else. Don't give him what he wants right away. It needs to be very slow. Give him a little more. And you know, people say, oh, well, John, some people, you're playing hard to get. I said, no, you're not playing hard to get. You're just not being insecure. You see, women, it's your insecurity. It's a desperateness. It's a confusion. It's where you feel like, oh, I have to give more to get more because I don't deserve it. You know, if I'm a plumber and I go to somebody's house, I have to do a good job in order to get paid. I'll feel terrible if I don't do a good job. I don't want the money. It's like you have to earn it. That's the male energy, has to earn. And women, when you're not married and you're in your 40s, you're independent, you're way on your male side. So there's this tendency all day long, I have to earn it, I have to earn it, I have to earn it. And then you get with a guy and suddenly you think you have to earn his love. You do not want the guy that you have to earn his love. You want a guy who just, ooh, I suddenly want her. And now I got to explore what this feeling's all about. And if you satisfy his want right away, he doesn't get a chance to connect with his female side, which is his need to be in a relationship with you and to feel love for you. Remember, the love comes from our female side, and it's the needing you. Oh, I'm hungry for you. I need you. And so you slow it down. Everything is slow it down. And, you know, when it comes to sex and intimacy, it's, you know, women feel the pressure. He's got this huge pressure because that's his job. His job is to get into the castle. Her job is to keep it locked until it's the right guy. And you know, these are kind of old fashioned ideas, but they're archetypal. And what happens is if a guy has sex with you right away, he will like you less afterwards in most cases. It's just simply because he hasn't yet bonded on an emotional level, on a mental level, on a spiritual level. He's just bonded with you on a physical level. And when he comes, the juice is left. It's just like he immediately repels back. And his brain becomes hypervigilant at that time to see what's wrong with you if he has sex right away. Just like I'm trying to teach as women at, on your dating thing, don't look for the right person. Otherwise, in advance, you're going to be looking for, you're going to be hypervigilant to, well, not about this, but what about this? What about this? What I suggest is, you know, have an easier attitude about it. My goal, the clarity of what I want is to create a series of positive dating experiences, whatever that means to you.